It's almost
Darwin Day!
How are you going to celebrate? Charles Darwin was born on February 12th, 1809. It's been 202 years since he was born, and 152 years since he published his revolutionary book and changed biology forever.
Let's celebrate!
Here are my top 10 ways to celebrate the birth of Charles Darwin.
Number 10, read!
Buy The Origin of Species and read it. You'll learn a lot. It'll be fun. There are lots of great additions, from the simple and cheap to the glossy and illustrated. The writing is accessible and poetic, with cool passages like,
"There is grandeur in this view of life. Whilst this planet has gone cycling on according to the fixed law of gravity, from so simple a beginning, endless forms most beautiful and most wonderful have been and are being evolved."
Also, check out the biology section of your local bookstore and library. You'll learn from other awesome authors about all we've learned in the 152 years since Darwin first published his amazing discoveries.
Number 9.
Watch. Snuggle up with your favorite person and some media masterpieces. If you're into cinematic flair, watch Creation, about the struggles Darwin had before publishing The Origin of Species. Or watch Inherit the Wind to see a classic dramatization of when evolution was first on trial in the United States. More in the mood for documentary style? Check out Nova's Judgment Day, Intelligent Design on Trial. Or just meet some amazing extinct creatures in shows like the BBC's Walking with Prehistoric Beasts. Or find anything with David Attenborough in it and watch that.
In this time, he, perhaps more than anyone alive, has seen evidence for evolution in the stunning diversity of nature.
Defined and filmed animals.
This is the biggest flower in the world.
The blue whale! The biggest creature that exists on the planet!
Number eight.
Laugh at the Darwin Awards, given to people who we're twistedly glad were removed from the gene pool. Okay, that's a little dark. Maybe just laugh at some of the goofy creatures and behavior produced by natural selection.
Number seven.
Meet your family. Yes, your family. You might think you know all your relatives, but you have approximately 6.9 billion close relatives right now, and more being born all the time. And that's just the human population. Don't get what I'm saying? Watch Spencer Wells explain in National Geographic's The Human Family Tree. Don't have time for a movie-length version of your family photo album? Check out Podholer 54's Human Ancestry Made Easy. Since we're related to everybody on Earth, take some time to learn about your amazing family. In the US, February is Black History Month. Start by meeting some history makers in Freethinker Chronicles, Greatest African American Freethinkers. Freethinking is the emancipation of the mind. We associate emancipation of the body from slavery with Abraham Lincoln. Lincoln was born on the same day in the same year as Darwin. That's a cool coincidence. Lots of other people were born on the same day, but they didn't affect history quite as obviously as these two. And hey, you're related to both of them! Now that you know you're related to everyone, go out and act like it. Treat people you meet with respect and kindness. Stop getting hung up on the 0.1% that makes us different. After all, genetically, you are more identical to a human on the other side of the world
than a chimpanzee is to a member of her own family troupe.
Number six.
Listen.
There are great songs which celebrate Darwin's discoveries and explore how related we are. Listen and love. This is Chumbawamba's Charlie.
All of nature in its place, by under the designer, comes up Charlie, spins the world from here to Asia Minor. In between the platypus and perfect Aphrodite, Charlie come with opposing thumbs to question the Almighty.
And the champion of all science music,
Symphony of Science!
Every cell is a triumph of natural selection, and we're made of trillions of cells. In us is a little universe. some of the things that molecules do. Given 4 billion years of evolution, we are each of us a multitude.
When you've listened to the entire Symphony of Science playlist, listen to the Technode versions and dance.
Standing on a planet, really I'm just a speck. I'm just a speck. Compared with the stars, the planet is just another speck. To think about all of this, to think about the vast emptiness of space. Billions and billions of stars. Billions and billions of stars.
Number 5. Learn. Why not spend Darwin Day learning about the theory which so revolutionized biology? The absolute best guide I've ever seen is Berkeley's Evolution 101. It's hands-on and simple, with lots of resources to help you delve as deeply as you want into scientific discoveries made since Darwin's time. Learn about the modern synthesis and how genetics have proven evolution's amazing history. Don't be shy, we're all novices to this field. Asking questions is how we learn. It's also how science is done. Ask a question, look for the answer. Like, why do baby humans have gill slits in the womb? Why do horses have 3 toes before they're born? Why do we share DNA with fungi? Why do platypuses have mammary glands? How do we know whales had land-dwelling ancestors? What are these transitional fossils people keep talking about? Go to Berkeley's site, you'll love it. Also, check out talkorigins.org for more info.
Number 4.
Support. Support free speech. Remember, Socrates was executed, among other reasons, because he dared to claim that lightning was a natural process, not a bolt from the gods. Galileo was put under house arrest for suggesting the Earth wasn't the center of the solar system. Without free speech, ideas like gravity, the sun-centered solar system, and evolution would have been squashed because they weren't popular. Stick up for ideas that may not be popular, but have evidence to support them. Support science. Donate to your local museums. Give to the National Science Foundation. Go to bat for science education. Let your political representatives know that proper science education is important for the future. Tell a local teacher you appreciate the work he or she is doing. Support humanitarian outreach. After all, Darwin helped us realize why this is so important.
As Darwin recognized, we humans are the first and only species able to escape the brutal force that created us, natural selection. We civilized men do our utmost to check the process of elimination. We build asylums for the imbecile, the maimed, and the sick. We institute poor laws, and our medical men exert their utmost skill to save the life of every one to the last moment.
Number 3. Go
to a museum. Look at a small slice of the evidence for evolution we've been accruing for over 100 years. Go to a zoo or an aquarium. Check out how different and how alike animals and plants are to each other and to you. Go outside and watch the native species around you. Marvel at how they've adapted to their environments.
Number 2.
Enjoy. Get active. Run around, dance, eat your favorite foods, smell flowers and leaves, look at the sky. Enjoy your wonderful, flawed but amazing body given to you by evolution. Enjoy your life. Enjoy the trees, the atmosphere, the grass, the other living things around you, and know that they could not be here without evolution. And neither would you. Revel in the fact that we are at the glorious position in history that people have figured this out and shared the information with you. Enjoy living, and you'll be honoring Darwin and all humanity all your life long. And share the joy.
Number 1. Share.
Most importantly, share what you learn with budding young minds. Tell a child or a friend or a family member how wonderful it is to be alive and how great it feels to know that we are all related to each other. Spread the word. Wear a t-shirt advertising the fact. Wear jewelry that does the same. Put a Darwin fish on your car. Okay, I don't put anything on my car either, but perhaps you could leave polite and informative notes on the cars with the ichthus eating the Darwin fish. Obviously, if the driver is interested in truth, he or she would be glad to know about Talk Origins and Berkeley's site, right? You can skip reaching out to the people with the Darwin fish inseminating the ichthys. They already understand the mechanisms of gene distribution. Share with the world. And share with us. How are you going to celebrate Darwin Day? Make a video, leave a comment, start a civil discussion. But remember to get away from the computer for a little bit and have fun with your relatives in real time. Happy Darwin Day!